Well, I think we've seen very promising results. We've seen that in the volunteers that have received the vaccine, it is very safe. And we've also seen that it stimulated the immune system. So I think we should be optimistic. And given the severity of the epidemic, we do need to move forward to the next phase.
Well, so far, the study hasn't run long enough for us to understand how long the T-cell response and antibody levels can last. Generally speaking, how long would we want this vaccine to be effective?
Well, we would definitely want the vaccine to work at least for 12 months. And, you know, with the flu vaccines, we re-administer flu vaccines every 12 months. So 12 months would be a reasonable schedule. Certainly, if it could be longer, that would be better.
Right. Now, the study was published in the Lancet magazine on Monday, and in fact, the results of another human trial in China were published in the very same issue of the journal. Talk to us about where we are globally on efforts to produce a vaccine.
Well, globally, we're making excellent progress. Remember, the genetic sequence of the virus was only released in early January. So now, in a little over 6 months, we have multiple vaccines that have been shown to be safe in humans to cause effective immune responses. And now we have to see, you know, with some type of challenge, either an experimental challenge or a natural challenge by immunizing individuals in an at-risk population with this ongoing transmission, how well does the vaccine actually protect against infection? But we're making progress steady. And what's very important is that the vaccine results so far show it is very safe.
Very safe. I mean, that is the big question, right? Because we typically see, trials go on for years. This one has been expedited at such staggering speeds. So where is that compromise? Why would it normally take so long versus now?
Well, I mean, the safety is really an issue of the numbers of people that are vaccinated, and the numbers of people that have volunteered has been tremendous so far. So we've seen a lot of enthusiasm from volunteers. We've seen a lot of, you know, countries want their populations to participate in a voluntary manner in these vaccine studies. So as we do these in many countries around the world, we can have a lot of volunteers and see the safety of the vaccine in a large number of people.
Doctor, the race to produce the first vaccine for COVID-19 has moved beyond just a public health issue, something of national pride even. And last week there were reports of claims that Russia was behind a hacking attempt to steal coronavirus vaccine. Do the politics help or hinder this whole process?
Well, I think the media attention to the importance of the vaccine, the national pride of who's going to be first bringing a vaccine forward are actually important, because they do, any trial requires a lot of, financial investment, but also requires human volunteers. And this is a great opportunity for people to, participate and to contribute to science and, make sure we have a safe and effective vaccine. And we've been very successful with other vaccines in the past. In fact, vaccines are our best tools for public health.
Well, encourage